Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world away, welcome to Monday. Just so you know, look, my finger's recovering from the little mishap on Friday. We've added the addition to a new sign in the workshop. I think that was a necessity, to be honest with you. We're going to be continuing with the penultimate episode of the Eagle Moss Build the James Bond DB5. So we're going to be doing stages 71 to 80. Can you believe how quick we've gone through this? So in the next stage, we're just going to be doing five stages together, but I understand that they're going to be a little bit difficult. Actually, there's going to be a lot more to do in today's one than we have throughout the whole of them. And that's pretty much why I've got this part work upgrades mat down here straight away, because we are going to be working with a lot of pieces from the bodyguard. I also have a little modification from Mike Lane to show you right at the end, just some detailing that we can actually put on the car as well, so be sure to stick around for the end so you can see me put those on as well. But we might as well just jump straight into it. Just so you know, I do not use the instructions that come with this magazine because they're all over the place. So I do use MarvelPHX's Todd McWilliams, myjamesbonddb5.com website, and that's the instructions I'm going to be following. So without further ado, let's get cracking. So it all starts with stage 71. Did you see the table vibrate then? This is an absolute ginormous piece of bodywork. Let's get this open, and there you go, check that out. This is ginormous and it's really heavy. Look at that compared to me. And this is just the back end of the vehicle. This is pretty impressive. Now, we do have the catch for the trunk already pre-installed in there, as you can see. But we are going to be fitting the lights that we had in the previous couple of stages in the last pack. So we've got this one here, and we've got stage 70 here, which I didn't even open in the last pack. We just got the lights in. So let's get these open as well. Now, we do have screws in here again. We've got 11 type A screws. So just wrote an A on those. And we've also got 7 type C screws, which I'll put a C on there as well. Now, the lights that we've got here, they have got a letter in the middle. As you can see, this one's a left side, and then this one here is a right side. So it's the right side one I'm going to need first. Just going to untangle the wire here, because I'm going to be putting that through the right-hand side light just there. Thread the wire through, and this is going to go on with the amber light facing upwards. Just like this. And there we go, that's in. Now that's going to be held in with a type C screw. So if I turn this upside down, and it's probably best on the top camera there, you can see, or actually the side camera, you can see how that light sits over that point that the wire's in the way there. That's where we're going to be putting the type C screw. And when that's in, it should look just like that. Do the same on the other side, put the cable through, make sure the amber light is the one at the top. So I'm doing it upside down, so I need to make sure that's on the bottom. Slide the light in, and then once again, a size C screw just down the top there is going to hold all of that together. So when they're in there, they look like that, and as you can see, they can actually go down to fire missiles and guns. People, which I think is pretty cool. And that, looking just like that, is all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 72, we've got some side panels here. We've got the switch that's going to operate the whole car, and we've got a hinge cover for this. So let's get all these out. So this is what the parts look like with the switch. And as you can see, you've got the on-off switch there. And we do have these side panels here, which have the seat belts already pre-installed on them. We are actually going to need this section here, which has got the bulletproof screen on, as you can see there, which comes up when you push it down. Now, over on the instructions, it's telling us to fit the switch section to the rear seat section now. But over on the My James Bond DB website, Todd's basically saying not to do that. So I'm going to follow MarvelPHX's instructions, and I'm going to do it my own way. So what we do, we're going to bring up this lovely section we just worked on with the lights in it, and we're going to be attaching the rear trunk section first, which is just going to go over the top like this. It sits flush in there like that. That looks excellent, doesn't it? Now I don't want anything to open here, so I am going to put some masking tape over the bulletproof screen. And I'm going to put some just down the side here, because I don't want this opening when I've got it upside down. This is light tack, so don't worry about it damaging the paintwork. Okay, I'm going to turn this over, just like this. And I'm going to attach the rear seat section that we worked on previously like that. Now, it's going to go on this way. This rod here is going to fit into the channel that you can just see there. So I'll put that in, but at the same time, I want the holes on this side here to fit over the lugs that are here and here. So I can put that in like this. And as you can see, they go over those two now. And that bar there is fitting into the middle like that. Perfect. Make sure that that's down over the lugs. And I'm going to be holding that in with two A screws. I have put these in oil. So that's one. And that's two. So both of those are now in place. Now we've got this hinge section into the channel there. We just need to secure that into place. To do that, we have got this section that looks just like that here. That's just going to go this way round, over the top, under here, like this. And as you can see, that's going to hold everything into place there. Now at the back two screws are going to be size C screws. And the second one just in here. The one at the back here is one of my old screws. It's a type L screw. And that's just going down the middle there. And there we go. That's all in place. So I can turn this back over now. And we don't need this tape on. But if I turn it back over, the bonnet is going to want to open. So just bear that in mind if we have to do that again. Now you can open this all the way up because you do have a catch just in here. So when this opens up, this catch can actually lock into that section there, you see. So if I was to give it a little bit of strength, the actual trunk boot will stay open just like that. And then just push it down to get it back down again. So I will just turn that over again just to sort these electrics out. Just make sure they're not in the way at the moment, because we are going to be putting a switch panel in. That is the switch panel that we were working on last time. Now, making sure these wires are out the way, I'm just going to put this into position here. Now, I don't know if you can see this. We've got three lugs. It's actually going to fit on the middle ones here. One and two. And once again, that's going to be held in position with two of the L screws that we just used. The first two are going to go into the front end just here. And then the points just down on these two sections here. It's saying on the My James Bond DB5 site that they never told us to put any screws in there. But I think Todd's right. We're going to be putting size A screws into those. And that will just hold down the back section as well. So if I turn that back over, we've done absolutely loads in that stage, as you can see there. And if I show you on the close-up camera, when I lift up the boot here and lock that into place, we now have the power switch here that I could turn off and on. I know that's impossible for you to see, so I'll show you on the top camera. You can see it in there like that. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 73, we're going to be working on the rear bumper. That looks like this, lovely and chrome. And these are actuators come out and in, as you can see, which is quite fun. We do have some screws in this one, so the little silver flanged ones here are size U, and the silver ones here are size P. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to bring over the rear section of the vehicle again we worked last time. We're actually going to be putting the bumper into place here. Now, if you are having trouble getting that in, make sure you've got the bumper in the right way. It should fit flush along the edges here, but that's all in. So let's put these screws in. One there. One on this side. And just one on the other side here. Excellent. So now that looks just like that. Things are going to get real now because I need to retrieve the roof section. Look at that. That we had previously, because we're going to attach that now. Now that's going to go over the top of this section, as you can see the holes here. So we're going to line them up. We need to put this lip here underneath the trunk section there when we do this. So this is going to be interesting. So the easiest way to do that is just lift the trunk up so that then that bit can go underneath. Line up both sides here. There we go, that's in the hole. Make sure that they're pushed all the way into those lugs. And it should fit flush all the way around. Which by the look of it, it does. That looks good. Like that. So once again, I'm going to turn this upside down. And I'm going to secure this in with some A screws. So the first ones I'm going to do are just at the back here. Make sure that's nice and tight. Do the same on the other side. Excellent. We've got two behind it. I don't know if you can see this, but there are two. I've just put these ones in. There are two just behind that point there and at the other side. And then finally, just right at the front here, there's another two. So when they're in, if I turn this back over, that should look like that, and it should be flush along the sides there. Now while I've got this upside down, we're going to be putting the side panels in now. So what we're going to do is this shaft here is going to go into the cavity that we can just see there. So when we push this in, it's going to fit over the top of those lugs there. So I'll do that now. Make sure we don't trap the seatbelt when we do this. And once it's in, as you can see there, it's fully engaged over the top of those locating lugs just there. Now that's held in with one A screw. Excellent. And we just do the same on the other side. So that's the two side panels in place. And that's what that's looking like at the moment. And that is all there is to do in that stage. It's coming along. We haven't had a pack like this for a long time. This is pack 74. Now we've got some screws here. These are silver type U screws. They're the flanged ones. We saw these earlier on. We have the antenna for the car there. And also we have one of the first lights there. But we don't do anything in this stage. So we can put them to one side and move swiftly on to the next stage, stage 75. So stage 75, as you can see, we've got some rails here, one and two, and we've also got another headlight here. But just like the last stage, we get to look at it, ponder it, and put that to one side. Okay, in stage 76, we've got the lifters here for the hood section of the car. And we've got the brackets for those as well. We've also got some screws here. These are tiny screws. These are size T. Now, these are metal, just so you know. And all we're going to do is we're going to take one of these, put it up along the side, and secure that with one of the size T screws. I'm so nervous when I screw like this, for obvious reasons, after Friday's little mishap. But there we go, that's in place. It should still be able to move, as you can see there. We do the same on the other side. That one's in place, and that, whoops, when I drop it, is all there is to do in that stage. Okay, you're gonna love stage 77. Check this beast out. It's ginormous. We're going to get this out. This is the car front. And there you go. Look at that. Looks pretty amazing. And that's how big it looks on the camera there. Wow. this does have lights pre-installed. As you can see here, these were already on there. Now we do have, put that to one side, we do have two lots of screws here. We've got the fine threaded ones here, which are A's. And we've got the other ones, which are C's. And as you can see at the front here, you've got little machine guns that come out. So you can just open and close that. That looks really good. So the first thing we want is, do you remember this? We're going to need the license plate with the revolving registration number there. That's going to go in here, and we have got a top to put on this here. We're going to put the top on. Now the top is curved, so it can only go on one way, just over the top like that, sealing everything in. That's going to be held in with two L screws. Now I've got one of them that I had previously, and the second one just in this side. Excellent. As you can see, we've got the number plate in here now, and we can just turn that over to exactly what we want. I like that one, so I'm going to keep it on that one. Now I'm going to bring up the main hood body, turn it over, and on these sections here I'm going to be putting in the hood supports. So one is going to fit on this side just over this lug here, and it is a tight fit, but it will go in just like that. And we'll do exactly the same on the other one here and push that into place. Oh, that was fun. We're going to hold them in with two C size screws, looking like that. So that's one and two. Now you see we've got these recesses in the body here, one and two. We're going to put those side rails in that we had in the previous stage, looking like that. Now they are directional. And the way they go in, you see the mold release marks here, you need to make sure that they face down. So when we put these in, you know what side they're going to go into, because obviously those sides are going to face down. So they just go in the side here and just push them into place like that. Do the same on the other side. And that's in perfectly. Now we need the wing mirrors. Now one of these came in stage 6, one of these came in stage 73, so hopefully you've still got these. I'm just looking at them, there are slight differences between them, and the difference is the curvature on this side on the underside will dictate where it's actually going to fit into the car. So I'm just going to put this one where it goes on that. If I try to put the wrong one in there, you can see it doesn't fit flush to where it needs to be. It sort of like wants to go off an angle, so the correct one is this one here. Now that's going to be held in with a P screw. Now obviously once these are in, we're going to be wanting to be careful when we actually turn it upside down. But that's one in. Do the same on the other side, and there we go, that's the two wing mirrors in. Excellent. Now we need the headlights. Now these are labeled left and right, so we'll do the left side first. We're just going to feed that through the center hole there, like that, then pull that through, and then that's going to sit in just like that there. Do the same on the other side, and that one's in too. And then we need the silver U screws to keep these into place. And there we go, that's the first light into place. Just do the same on the other side. And that's both the headlights in place. Just at the front here, we're going to be putting the Aston logo motif. Now that came, I believe, in pack one, which I've got here. And as you can see, there's a little bit of sticky there, double-sided sticky tape that we can just take the adhesive backing off like that. And then quite simply, we're just going to push this into place like that. And there we go, that's the motif on. And then the last thing we want to do is we want to take the antenna here that we had again in the previous pack. That's just going to go into this section just here. So we're going to push that in. And then once that's in, as you can see, the antenna can go up and down, up and down. And that was a wonderful pack, that was, is all there is to do in that stage. Now in pack 78, we've got the parts for the suspension assembly. Now I'm going to show you a picture of what all of those parts look like. And the reason I'm only showing you a picture is because we don't actually use them at the moment. So I am going to keep them safely in the bag here. It doesn't mean there's not anything to do though, because we have got to fit the bonnet. And that means we're going to need a few items for this stage. We're going to need the grill that came in pack one. We're going to need the radiator and bonnet hood. They came in pack 37. We're working our way through them. We're going to need the front bumper base. Looks like that. I think that came in page 38. And we're obviously going to need the car front body and the front bumper that we've been working on. I think that was stage 77. So I have got the bonnet here, and that's the first thing that we're going to be installing. So I'll bring up the section that we've been working from. Just make sure that these cables aren't pinched inside there. I don't want them being trapped, because I'm going to put the bonnet in here, and quite simply it just goes in like that and then shuts like that. And I am going to put some masking tape around here, because there's going to be a lot of times that we're going to be turning this upside down. So just be careful of your wing mirrors. So now that's in place, I'm just going to turn that upside down. Take the front bumper base part, which looks like that. And that's going to go over the hinge there. Don't know if you can see that on the close-up camera there. It's going to be secured in with two C-type screws. So I've got them here. Let's put these in. One in this side, and just one in the other side. So then we're going to take the front bumper base. That's just going to go, these two lugs here are just going to go into the recesses that we can just see there. So I'm going to put that in like that. And then it's going to be attached with the two lugs that we've got there, or the two holes, sorry, that we've got probably best on top camera, here and here. They're going to be held in with type A screws. And then we need two more AA screws just going into these points at the bottom here. So when that's in, that should look like that. Turn it over, and then we want to take the radiator here. That's going to fit in this way, just over the top of what we've done there. I'm just going to push that onto the lugs, and they're going to be secured in with type L screws. So that's one, and just one at the top there. That's two. Nice and secure. Then we're going to put the front bumper on. Can't wait to get this on. So that's going to go on this way. I'm just going to put this through the front here. Having a little wiggle around to make sure that this is sitting in right. That looks perfect there. I like that. Now the L screws that we put in before is actually what's going to hold this into place. So what you want to do is just loosen them, push it to where it goes. Might take a little bit of wiggling, and then tighten them up. Just like that, and that holds securely. Excellent technique there, and as you can see, that's now on. I think that's great. I don't want to really change this number plate, but I will. Let's just turn it to that one for now. Now, it doesn't ask us to do it in the main instructions, but you can optionally now put the grill in, which I'm going to do, because it is another piece which isn't in a box somewhere. And there's just three lugs to push into place here. So now, that looks iconic, the front, doesn't it? I love that. And then we can actually take off the masking tape that we put on here, lift up the hood, which obviously lifts up from the other side, silly me. And we're just going to show you how the hoods work, the hood supports. As you can see, they just go under there. So that's how the hood goes up there. What an amazing pack. That looks absolutely brilliant. I've got a little bit of dust on the bonnet here. I don't know how I've done that, because this has been stored in a lunchbox. So, but there you go. So if I just put these down, just so you can see what that looks like when it's closed. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 79, we've got another part here and some screws, which are some pins. And we've also got one of the axles, but we don't actually use that in this stage. We can keep that to one side. Bring up this section again, because we're actually now going to be installing the doors. So the first thing I want to do is I want to tidy these wires up by putting them in this channel here. So I'll do that now. And then I'm going to install the doors. So I'm going to do the right hand side door first. While it's upside down, I think that's probably the best way to keep this in. So that's going to go the hinge side. You've got two lugs here. Just going to go into the hole at the side there. Making sure we're not pinching any wires. Just like that. Now it's going to be held in with one screw here, which is a size M screw. M screws are flanged and quite short. So I'll get that in. You do want this to be in really tight because you don't want that door wobbling around. And there we go, that's the first door in. And in a similar fashion, we're just going to do the same thing on the other side. And there we go, they're all in place. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Check that on the side camera. Looking pretty amazing. Now I may as well just leave the car here for stage 80, because stage 80 is the electronics board, which looks like this, but we don't actually fit it in this stage. So I'm just going to show you what that looks like. And I think I'll tidy this up and we'll just have a quick review of everything we've done today. So we've got this side of the vehicle here. And as I demonstrated earlier, we know this lifts up and down, looking like that. And then we've worked on this whole back section of the vehicle here, which I'm not going to put on now, but I'm going to give you an idea. If I just open the doors slightly of how this is going to go, it's going to kind of go on like that, I'm guessing. You get the idea. I think this whole section here is going to fit underneath that section there. But yeah, obviously that's going to have to fit onto a rolling chassis, which is what I guess we're going to make next time. But yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. That looks good. Obviously, we've done the trunk as well, which has got the switch in. I don't want to tangle these electrics up, but I am liking how that looks. So what do you think of that? That's pretty amazing, wasn't it? I'm just going to show you quickly some of the decals that you can get from Mike Lane. I was going to install them in this one, but I think it's probably more sense to wait till the car's actually finished and put them on then. They look just like this. I put a link down to Mike Lane's website at the bottom here. And as you can see, you have got all the emblems and badges which would go onto the car. And in the instructions here, it tells you exactly where everything goes on the car and how to apply them as well. Again, this is available from MikeLaneMods.com. I will put them in on, we'll put them on the last episode, which is going to come next week. Now, there's only five stages in the next episode, but we need to assemble the whole bottom chassis of the car. So there is going to be quite a bit to do in those five stages, I'm sure. But we've done a lot today. That's why the video's out slightly later than normal, because it's taken, I don't know, we're talking about 2 hours to build all of that section. So I'm going to edit that down now. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.